Bassem Youssef is a former heart surgeon. He's now a comedian. As the Gaza war broke out, he became a voice for Palestinian people everywhere. He made headlines during a viral interview with my colleague Piers Morgan, where he used his sharp brain and black humour to present his side of the argument. He's not without empathy for Jewish people, but he admits that he's biased to the Palestinian cause. He's upfront about that. And yes, he condemns Hamas. Bassem Youssef has brought his comedy and wit to Australia for the first time. He's in Sydney. He invited me to meet him in Lakemba in southwestern Sydney yesterday as he met with members of the Palestinian community. I accepted his offer.
Bassem, you are a very busy man, but you've made time in your schedule to come and speak to this community. Why?
Well, I do that in all of my comedy tours, whether or not, like, I mean, like people have... some people around the world have started to know who I am through the recent interviews, but as a comedian, when I travel to a different place, I like to meet the local communities. It gives me material, and I use it, and people feel seen and heard when I use that in my comedy. But also, I am very lucky and I'm very grateful to work in a profession where you get to get your income through traveling all around the world and making people laugh. So if I have this opportunity to travel and see different communities, it will be a waste not to explore the communities. It adds more to me and to my knowledge and to my my awareness towards the world that we live in. I visit different communities, various communities all around the cities that I visit to do the show. So it's a human experience.
And this community is hurting right now, as is the Jewish community. Australia is a world away from Gaza, but it's so close for these people. How do you explain to Australians the intergenerational trauma, which I might say is on both sides?
Well, you know, I mean, I will be biased to one side, of course, but like I understand that, like, I think everyone is deserve to be heard, whether you're Jewish, whether you're Muslim, whether you're Palestinian, whether you're Israeli. Everybody needs to be heard. And you will find certain people that they will feel that their voices are not heard enough. They're not being represented enough. So I think if we can sit down as like a decent dialogue where everybody could say their piece and they can tell their stories. And when we listen to each other, I think we'll have more empathy towards each other's problems and hurt and pain. And we can see others, people, pain and grievance and react to that and have empathy towards that.
At a time like this, I think we all look to simplify it in our own minds. And there's not a lot of nuance in this debate. Bassem, I know you've thought deeply about this. You've done long interviews with my friend Piers Morgan. How do we get nuance back into the debate, and why do you think it's so important?
Well, I think the problem is that, how the news is set up right now. It's set more of a kind of a sensational show, which has only time for the short sound bites and sensational words. But I think, and I understand how it comes from, like, because from an average American or European or Australian, they only have that much time to watch entertainment or sports. So when they are exposed to the news, if it's not interesting and sensational, they might turn off, and that's why the sensations happen. So it is a difficult question to answer. And I think that when we have a much more nuanced, deep conversation, you mentioned Piers. The second interview, I really loved talking to Piers. We talked as friends. Piers is not my enemy. He's a wonderful person, and off camera, he's a very charming personality. And whatever you see on maybe it could be part of his personality, but it's also the persona. He is there to ask hard questions, to ask maybe questions that would kind of push your buttons, but that's his job, you know, to go and adopt the opposite side. So you will have like, you will challenge whatever point of view that we have. But when I sat with him, not with wanting to have a debate or to win a debate, but to have a conversation. And I think it worked. I think people have had a chance to listen more, to understand more, to search more. And this, I hope that we have more of this, of kind of like deep, nuanced, complex conversation so that we can listen to each other instead of talking over each other.
I wanted you on my show, and you insisted I come here today, and I was very willing to do so. Why?
Well, first of all, I didn't have time. Because I'm doing nine shows in 6 days.
Yeah. So it you wanted me to sit with this community.
Because I want you to, like, as a news reporter, I think it will be useful for your viewers to have more than, like kind of like quick sound bites, but kind of like talk to the people. I think if you want to discuss the news, you talk to the people. If you want to discuss events, you talk to the people. If you want to discuss conflicts, you talk to the people, because at the end of the day, it's about people. So when you speak to the people and get into their lives and their daily lives and have like more of a human approach of a problem, of a conflict, I think that would be a much better way to discuss complex ideas and conflicts, and we can see each other as humans at the end of the day.
Okay, well, I'm going to let you go. It's often said that being a comedian is one of the most dangerous jobs in the world right now, but comedy has been so powerful over the last 4 weeks. Have you been reminded of that?
Well, I mean, as long as I sell tickets, I'm very happy. So it can be as dangerous as they want.
You're not as frivolous as that. You're a little bit more deep, aren't you?
No, I try to be as shallow as possible. It helps me. It helps my comedy.
All right, we'll see you at the Opera House.
Thank you so much. Thank you.